So first thing in this pose is dandasana. Dandasana has to be proper right. And remember, lotus pose is the super advanced pose in yoga. Handstand is not that advanced. Elbow stand is not that advanced. Lotus is advanced. Because the final destination of a yogi is when the lotus is easy and can sit 1 hour non-moving. Whole yoga movement you are doing for what? Stillness. So keep moving your body at least one day, either in lotus pose, either in easy pose, either in siddhasana pose. You can stay for 1 hour non-moving. That is the challenge if you ask me. That is the advancement of yoga. So how to do the lotus? So first you have to do external rotation on one hip joint properly, because if external rotation is not happening properly, knee will not be comfortable, back will not be comfortable. Now from here, when you come closer, if your feet stay here, knee joint still getting pressure, your heel has to come closer to the hip, only the knee is out of pressure. Clear everyone? Then, I'm not saying you flex or point, just gently keep the space between the ankle joint. Clear everyone? I'm not killing the space. Keep the space in the ankle joint and don't allow the foot to sickle also. So if you see here, I'm just using my toes but not using my ankle to activate my foot. I'm not doing this. There is a space, but foot is here and then the arch is active there, so my knee is safe. Now I am not, this is the wrong way to pull the leg. This is going to disturb the knee joint, very wrong way. Closer, look at, see what way I am using, sliding. Understood? Sliding, but not in this way. I am keeping my foot aligned, sliding, sliding, and I am keeping it aligned. So because if it goes in, it goes in, pressure here. If this goes out, this goes out, pressure here. So I am keeping it here because I have tendency to get pressure here in this joint, in this pose. So I have to open it like this. Pressure gone for me. So I have to maintain this here, pressure gone. Heel to the inner abdominal area. When it has come, look at this, foot is already in external rotation. So once this happens, I am again taking care, no pressure here, and my foot is gently active onto the inner abdomen, and I am not allowing my arch to be killed, keeping it gentle here. Then externally rotation coming here. Good, one step is complete. Now again, I am not pulling it up, I am checking there is any pressure on the knee. I am a bow leg person, so I always get pressure here. So I release it like that, like moving the quads, moving the calf. Then slide, again, look at the foot. I'm not allowing this sickle foot to come up. Foot is there, so ankle, everything is remain out of pressure. Then slowly sliding, checking any pressure, no. If I'm doing this, I'm getting pressure here. This pressure is gone. Now bring the heel to the inner abdomen here again. Checking any pressure, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure. My this knee is still slightly coming up, so give me a blanket. I will use a support under this knee. Alright, now. Safer here. Good. So here is my lotus pose here. Clear everyone? Understood it? Now if people are advanced, they can go more forward in this pose when shin bone come over the shin bone, like crossing each other. Like so shin over the shin, this is the actually the real lotus, which actually keep your spine erect so energy can move upward. This is the advanced position of lotus pose. This pose is a meditative pose for a yogi. But in the current century, hips are tight, knees are tight. This is the most killer pose for the knee and hip area. No need to do if it is not happening right. You can do half lotus. Half lotus is same thing. One foot down. All right. I can meditate in this pose. Why to take problem for the knee? Clear everyone? Mm-hmm. Same thing, but one foot goes under the knee. Half lotus. Are we clear about it? Mm-hmm. Understood everyone? Any question? Clear this pose? Any point which has not been clear? If it is happening, good. If it is not happening, very good. So this is lotus pose. Now I am going to give you Siddhasana.